The two main challenges with attempting to restore the gold filigree work on antique sewing machines, such as this 1888 swan neck by Jones, are matching the metallic luster and the color of the gold filigree. I tried several paints, but I found I couldn't maintain enough control over the brush strokes to get a good job, so I decided to focus on markers. I got 8 of the best markers, gold leaf type markers I could find, and they are the Krylon 18 karat gold leafing pen, the Duco color gold, Duco gold leaf, Pabio gold deco marker, Sharpie metallic, Pentouch Calligrapher Shiny Metallic Gold, Pilot Gold Marker, and Pentouch Shiny Metallic Gold. The first thing I'd like to report is that all 8 pens dried within minutes and adhered very securely to the glossy black enamel finish of the sewing machine. The Krylon 18 karat gold leafing pen, the Deco Gold, and the Deco Gold Leaf all had the same color and the same amount of luster. They covered well and went on about the same. The Pabio Deco Marker was actually a glitter marker, a very fine glitter in a transparent carrier. It tended to drop down to the bottom, the glitter fell to the bottom, so this was not a good selection. The Sharpie gold metallic pen had about the best coverage. It was the smoothest and the easiest to put on. Also, it had a very fine point, so you could do fine detail. All of these have chisel points, or the paints are so thick that it's difficult to do fine work with. The Pentouch Calligrapher Shiny Metallic Gold was one of my least favorites. It has a very distinctive green sheen to it. It also went on very streaky, very difficult to get even coverage. The two most realistic gold markers were the Pilot Gold Marker and the Pentouch Shiny Metallic Gold Marker. These produced a lustrous, very believable gold metallic look that was really the best of all of them. They're a little bit yellower than some of these others, which make them more believable, but although it's not easy to see in this image, these two have a real metallic, shiny looking luster, almost like gold. So I would rate these the best. However, none of these have the right color to match the existing antique gold finish. Fortunately, there's a solution for that. As you can see now, the colors are much closer to the antique gold, particularly the Deco Colored Gold and the Pilot Gold Marker. What I did is I went over each of the golds with a Sharpie light orange permanent marker. I believe this color is leg warmer orange. It changed the hue of the gold to be a perfect match for the antique gold. What's nice about this technique is that by using more or less of the orange overlay, I can fine-tune the color tint to make a perfect match with the existing gold. So, my recommendation would be to use the Deco Color Gold and go over it with the Sharpie light orange marker to create the color gold you need to match. The Pilot Gold Marker was also very good and actually had a better shine, but this is a very thick ink and it adds some texture to the gold filigree, which is not going to be consistent with the very flat, very smooth texture of the original appliques. Using this two pen technique, I've been able to repair and actually replace all of the leaves from here to here on the back of the swan neck. And although it's difficult to see with this lighting, in person they're a perfect color match to the remaining filigree. So, if you have a vintage antique sewing machine and it's got some damaged filigree and you want to repair it, give this technique a try and I think you'll be pleased with it. Also, if you'd like to see more about sewing machines or hundreds of other topics, I hope you'll visit my main website, waynesthisanddat.com. Thanks for watching.